Looking back, his progress seemed seamless. The capture of the Torbay Lass, Waddle's decision to declare himself unwell and go ashore rather than face a daily accusation of cowardice, facilitating Nelson's elevation to first lieutenant. The joy of serving with Locker in that rank, harrying the enemy trade, taking capture after capture, had been huge. But even that paled when he was given command of a schooner, taking charge of a capture brought into the service by the newly arrived admiral on the station, Sir Peter Parker. 6 months' independence ended abruptly when Sir Peter, a friend and admirer of his uncle Morris, took him into his own flagship as third lieutenant. There was no better station than the West Indies for rapid promotion. The climate and disease saw off more senior officers than enemy action, and the ships that became available went to those closest to the admiral. Within 4 months, he had progressed from third to first lieutenant, and 2 months later, he was appointed as master and commander to the sloop HMS Badger. He had enjoyed his 6 months in Badger, free at last to make his own decisions, to mould a crew in an image personal to him. While he could never be sure, Nelson hoped that the men had responded to his easy-going, friendly manner, his way of treating them like human beings instead of cattle. Opportunity was multiplied by the entry of the French into the American War, even more so when Spain was dragged in on Gallic coattails. Together, they had earned his ship and its commander an enviable reputation for activity and zeal that augured well for future promotion. But the truth that nothing could be guaranteed came home to him the day he had learnt that his Uncle Morris had died at Greenwich of a paralytic seizure. There was compensation in the will, from which he received a bequest of £500, plus the assurance of the last words Morris Suckling had said to his father, words that he had read several times.